Good morning. My hair is a little straight today. Well, straight, flat, I guess is the correct term. I bought a Funko Pop recently and it just arrived. This is my first My Hero Academia Pop. I got Suyu, also known as Froppy, and she is adorable. I will admit, I think her skin tone seems to be a little bit off, but it's not a big deal. She also comes with a little stand, but she doesn't need it. She stands up perfectly fine by herself, so I'm not gonna use the stand. She's gonna be the only one that I keep out for now. I think I'm just gonna put her like up there behind my monitors. Yeah, I like her, she's cute. I was gonna say, you know who else is cute? Minnie, but she's not in here anymore, so never mind.
Minnie. That's a nice hat, Min.
I just got back from a quick trip to Walmart, and by a quick trip, I mean like an hour and a half long trip because it was a fairly far away Walmart, because I was looking for a game. This game I decided to buy this morning because a sequel to it, or sequel, was announced. Hyrule Warriors Age of Calamity was announced today, which is going to be a new Hyrule Warriors game, but also a prequel to Breath of the Wild, which I'm super excited about. So that made me want to pick up Hyrule Warriors Definitive Edition for Switch so that I can play through it fully, hopefully, if I have the time, before the new game comes out. Now, I already owned the Wii U and 3DS versions of the game. I've done them on Quick Play, I've played a bit more of this one, but I had barely played it at all, basically. So I decided, you know what, I'm gonna pick up the Definitive Edition for Switch, we're gonna do that, we're gonna play through that one, and the gang's all here. Gang's all here with light reflecting on them, but the gang's all here. So I'm pretty excited about that. Pretty excited to own that. I'm also even more excited about the announcement of the Breath of the Wild prequel, because that means we're gonna get to play through the story that is only hinted at in the actual, like, original game. They always talk about, oh, all this stuff happened 100 years ago, but you don't get to play any of it, or you don't even get to see most of it. And I think it fits incredibly well in the Hyrule Warriors, or in the Dynasty Warriors style, because, you know, it was a war, so it makes sense. Comes out in November. I'm super excited. We got games on games on games. We got the Mario 3D Collection coming out in like 10 days. We've got Pikmin 3 Deluxe coming out in October, admittedly right at the end of October. And then we've got Hyrule Warriors Age of Calamity coming out in November. There's a lot of Nintendo stuff coming out that I'm excited for.
It's a very minor thing, but this is probably the first time I've worn a t-shirt in months. Like, I cannot remember the last time I wore something that has sleeves. And that's,
Well, okay, that's not true. When I had that video interview last week, I decided to wear a shirt with sleeves. But that was only for that interview. I took that off right after. But, yeah, I've been wearing this today because, as you can maybe see back there, I got the window open because it's finally starting to cool down. Let me look up what the actual temperature is right now, because it's 60 degrees. Tomorrow it's going to be about 66. Okay, so it is kind of rising over the next few days. 66 on Wednesday, 65 on Thursday, 71 on Friday. My mind just went a little bit. Wednesday, tomorrow, 66. Thursday, 65. Friday, 71. Saturday, 75. Sunday, 77. So it is going up, but like evening time, it's real nice and real cool. I am not complaining because it is so nice to not sweat, let me tell you. I didn't realize just how much I missed sitting here and being comfortable, you know, not being like, well, sweaty. So tomorrow I'm going into work because of course I am, because I gotta do my last day. Technically, I don't start my new job until next week, but I wanted a little bit of a break between jobs, so that's how we're doing this. I'm gonna go in tomorrow so I can say my goodbyes to people, have one last day working with the people that I like from that job. Hopefully they don't try to send me to the pick department. That's really gonna suck if they do. And then I'm gonna have Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday off. Monday is like a meeting thing at 1:30 p.m. I don't know what exactly that's gonna be, but I'm going in for that on Monday. And then Tuesday is my first official day, which is gonna be an orientation day, and they want me to go in at 9 a.m. until 3 p.m., which isn't the schedule I'm gonna be on, But I guess that will all be figured out on that day. I guess maybe that'll be where I learn stuff about my schedule, because I actually don't know what kind of schedule I'm going to be on just yet. What I said I wanted was the... Well, they didn't have first shift, so it would be second shift, 3 p.m. till 11:30 p.m., and that would be Monday through Friday. So I'm really hoping that's what they give me. That would be real good. The one thing I do know for sure, though, is this is a full-time position. If it was a part-time position, I wouldn't have been taking it, and I would not have been, you know, slaving over trying to get information about it for all this time. But yeah, that's my upcoming week. As for what I did today, I worked on a bit of a secret project that I'm working on with Dan. You know, worked on a bit of a trailer for that. Haven't quite got it finished yet, but we're getting close, I think. We're doing a skit for it, and we were gonna film that today, but we both got a little caught up in other stuff. So, well, I woke up late, and Dan was busy as well, so didn't quite get all that done, but it's not a big deal. I also tried out Mario Kart Tour again. It has been a hot minute since I actually played that game. And it's still kind of the same for me. Like, I don't care for it. I wish I did. I really wish I did. But, like, the fact that it's a gacha game, which means getting the characters is completely random chance. Getting all the carts and gliders and everything is random chance. And also the cups and the actual courses, so you can't really see it, but they cycle out every month. Or every time they do a new tour, these all cycle out, so you don't... Okay, I don't know what's going on. So you don't get to play the same courses all the time. That's also why I haven't, like, done any videos on it. I think I might do a quick play. I wasn't originally going to do a quick play, but they recently added a thing where... Well, before you had to play in this orientation. Now you can actually play like this. Also, look. Where is he? Steven George. There he is. Yeah, they added that recently, so you can... play in landscape, which would make making a video a lot easier. So maybe I'll do a quick play, but I'm not going to be doing a full let's play unless they add an option to just play through all of the cups, all of the tours and everything whenever you want, just not online, which I don't think they're going to do. Anywho, that's going to do it for today. So thank you all for watching. Stay tuned for tomorrow, and I'll see you guys then.